Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and we are looking at the Rockwood Rue 19. Cool features on here is one, the easy setup bed. So the cool things about Rues or hybrids or expandables, whatever name you want to give them, they do give you all the sleeping capacity without all the extra length. So this guy for length, or for weight, I should say, only weighs 37.79. So that's pretty lightweight for a travel trailer. The way this guy works is the handles are nice and down low instead of up in the middle where somebody shorter can't reach them. And they lock at the top, so it's gonna keep it tighter so when rain rolls down and stuff like that, you don't have to worry about that getting into your coach. Another thing that you'll like is all the bed ends are permanently attached all the way around. So you don't have to worry about rolling out of bed or kids rolling out of bed or your keys falling out onto the ground or whatever. So permanently attached. The material here is more of like a vinyl material instead of a canvas. And so that makes it a lot more waterproof. And then all of this is folded over four times and double stitched. And it's used, they use a special type of thread that is resistant to UV damage and stuff like that from the sun. So they've really thought through this. They've been building these for a long, long time, and they've kind of learned the tricks of the trade of how to make a good expandable. Two 20-pound propane tanks. This does have the electric tongue jack on the front, so you can easily put it up and down with like a weight distribution hitch or an equalizer hitch, which I do recommend. I think they make a big difference when you're pulling down the road, so make sure you ask about that. You also need a brake controller if you're going to be pulling something like this, or any travel trailer really, you'll have to have a brake controller. So we can help you set that up. We have a full parts and service department and can line up just about anything and everything that you can think of. This does have the power awning on it, so it's one push button awning to get it in and out. This does also have the solar power port here, so if you wanted to plug in a solar panel, it's really easy to do. We sell those again in our parts store, and you can set it out and catch the sun rays. You can do that or put it on top of the roof, either way. The nice thing about having them portable ones is if you're underneath some trees or something like that, you can put it off to the side so you're catching some more sunlight to get your batteries charged. Of course, it is convenient to have it mounted on top of the roof too, just for convenience sake. And say you get sunlight 70% of the time and maybe a couple trips here and there you don't get to use it because you're underneath the trees. We can set it up either way. We have a full service crew to help install those things if you want. This does come with the outside grill, cable outlet, so if you wanted to put your TV up here you can with a 110 power deal here. Outside speakers, this is a spot for the stovetop to let out all the smoke and stuff like that. This has the frameless automotive windows, so there's no rubber seal on the inside of here that kind of dries out and shrinks and stuff over time. Torsion suspension, so it gives you independent suspension. There's basically three rubber rods inside there, and the way that works is it's on an arm, and those rubber rods get kind of torqued as you're going down the road, and it's more maintenance-free, they last a lot longer, and it's a smoother ride. Radial tires that are filled with nitrogen, so that gives you a better handling, longer life, improved fuel economy, better braking. So yeah, some nice features there. And the aluminum rims instead of the white painted ones, we optioned it like that because they look nicer, one, but two, they don't rust out either. This does have a nice screen door, so if you wanted the screen door there, you can, for to let some nice air flow through. A large grab assist handle instead of the small one. So, you know, it's just easier to get up and down. Double step entry instead of a single step entry. And if you notice back here, they have the hard, spare tire carrier cover on here instead of a fabric one. So it's gonna last a lot longer. As we go over to this side, I'll show you that this has the, before I go too further, this has 12 volt heat pads on the elbows as well as on the tanks themselves to protect you down to negative 11 degrees. So this is ready for some colder weather, although the canvas will play a factor into that too. But Again, this has some nice flexibility where you don't have to put the beds out if you're going camping. You could leave those up, sleep on the dinette and the couch, and you'd be good to go. And then when you needed more space during the summertime, let's say, you put those out and you have two more queen size beds. 30 amp connector here with the LED light, so it's really easy to see if you have power coming from your pedestal or not. So it makes it for easy troubleshooting. This has the outside shower with hot and cold water ran to it, and then a little spot to hang it on as well. Cable satellite in here. The hot water heater is gas electric DSI, so can give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. And it has the easy winterize feature, so you can hook up your hose right here for antifreeze, turn a valve, and suck antifreeze through here instead of having to take apart your water pump to do that. And a nice little storage spot to put like your chalk blocks or you know, all your little stuff that you need to get to from the outside. Let's take a look at a few of the things on the inside. One of the cool features on here is the monitor panel, and I like that they've put it all in one place. So you have a button for your tank heaters, and it's easy to tell if you're turning them on and off, as well as your electric and your gas are both controlled over here instead of only having access to your gas on the outside. Water pump, monitor panel, this is for your awning to turn your awning out and back in, as well as an awning light, porch light, and interior lights. Another cool thing that you don't know until you get your camper a lot of times, sometimes these interior lights turn like one light on. This one turns all the lights on, all six here, plus the one in the entry here. So it makes it so that it lights up the coach really fast. You do have individual lights underneath the kitchen, I should say, so you can just push one button to turn those on. This has a stone casted sink, high-rise sink faucet, glass cooktop. Hey Tom, how's
What's
it going,
on, man?
I'm
did you start without
with
me?
I you, did.
Well, sorry, man. I had to take a break. Well, not a break, but I had to go sell a camper.
All right.
And you like it when I sell
that's
campers, and that's really my job. So you started without me.
Yeah, so we did the outside, and we are just starting to show them some stuff on the inside.
Oh, fantastic. So what can I help you with?
Well, tell me about this coach. I don't know.
You know all about this coach. So the 19 Roo is super awesome, right?
Yeah.
Super duper awesome.
I love how, you know, if I had to get a coach and only pick one, mm-hmm. I would probably pick an expandable because then I could pull it with any vehicle pretty much that I would get, you know, within reason. I could sleep any amount of people and I could even leave it folded up if I was going on a trip and just needed two, you know, spots to sleep.
Yeah, the Roos offer a huge diversity as far as camping. You know, don't have to deploy the beds if you don't want to. You can leave it as a four-sided hardwall camper if you want to, sleep on this, sleep on the couch, whatever your preference is going to be. That's what I like about the Roos. The Roo 19, though, this one does not come with a slide. They don't have that feature in here, but it's not designed to. It's designed to stay nice and compact for you, keep it kind of on their smaller side so people can still have the benefits of the canvas, but be able to button up when they need to.
Yeah, under 4,000 pounds.
Yeah.
I really like how these couches work, too, for turning it into beds.
Sure, I do, too.
And I like that you still have a little bit of walking room in between here. So if somebody's sleeping here, and I'll show you how to finish setting this guy up. So it's just a long pole. And you're set up.
Hey, mate, check it out.
Go for like the ultra deluxe.
This is like the ultimate long way king size bed.
Yeah, that's right.
You didn't think about this.
I don't think your sheets might not fit quite right if you went for this.
No? You don't think so? Sleeping bag?
That's true.
You could be in a sleeping bag. Look how much room I got though, man. Dude, this. I think I created something new here.
Yeah.
Someone's going to watch this and say, hey, man, this guy's got a great idea. You never thought about it, though, honestly, did you?
You know, I probably wouldn't need quite that much room.
If you just need to chill and relax, this is the setup.
Yeah.
Don't tell Ryan I kind of came up with this. This is an actual. I just came up with this just now. I'm like, man, that would be awesome if I could turn this into a king size bed.
Yeah.
And I just did.
That's true.
Pretty cool, huh?
This does lift up, so if you needed to access some stuff underneath here, I forget how to do this, though. Is it from the back or from the front that you lift this guy up? Oh, it's
no, you got it.
Yep. So
it's just a little.
Yeah. So this lifts up. You can access your stuff that you need to from the underside. Oh, there's our pillow.
Oh, another throw pillow.
Throw pillow.
Love that feature.
I'm learning.
You got to have the throw pillows, man. That's like a necessity feature in every coach now. If it doesn't have throw pillows,
it's worthless.
It's worthless. It truly is. Yeah, but anyways, this can make a separate bed. This is still big enough. I can still sleep on this if I needed to. Yeah. I actually like the king size bed model.
Yeah, you're going though, king size bed model.
I think so.
This does have paper towel holder that you can put on wherever, or we'll help you put it on. 10,000 gallon water filtration system that filters all the water in the entire unit.
Spatula that you're going to get with your outside grill.
Exclusive
nice
Forest River spatula.
Yes, it actually says Forest River on here, and it's got the beer top for me and Octavio. Would you say hard apple cider?
Yeah, or if you got some peach mousse.
Peach, what is that?
That's the one I've been asking for years, and nobody ever gives it to me.
Dude. And I gotta work.
So if
with
you
this
come
guy.
Up with a peach mousse beer, I'll try it.
Yeah, the plug-in for the beds, which are nice. So did you talk about that?
No.
So the heated mattresses, and then this will be the same on all the roofs. So you have a heated mattress option on here. Now you do have to be plugged into 110 power to operate this little feature. But the cool thing is that you can turn this and adjust the heat on here, 1 through 6 knob, 1 through 6 on here on the knob, on the dial here. And you can kind of control your heat. And we all know that we all sleep better when it's a cooler temperature. And what's really nice about the ruse is you can open up the sides, let the breeze blow in, regulate that body temperature really nice, and then kind of be nice and cozy up underneath the sheets and have the heated mattress. That's when you get your best sleep. You know, there was a study done on that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there was.
I probably, you know, as long as I have a ton of pillows around me, that's what I care about. So my wife, I drive her crazy, I think. I like to have like 5 or 6 pillows like surrounding me when I sleep.
Really?
Yeah.
Goodness.
Yep.
God, how can someone need all that many pillows, right?
I don't know. So
you sleep weird, mate.
You do have, if you need some external noise to sleep with, you do have some fans that can plug in right above your bed with a little nice reading light. It has a dim feature and a bright feature, so you can go either way on that. There's one for each bed end for here.
Yeah, and it's a nice little reading light, too. For that purpose, so it's good.
Yeah,
nice cargo nets up above here, which is kind of cool. And did I cut you off, mate?
This
is a. Sorry, man.
That's all right, man.
Well,
we'll forgive you this time.
Okay, appreciate it.
So this is a handy dandy handle to get your
water
filtration.
Off.
Yes.
There you go.
Took me a minute there.
That's okay.
I made it. Through.
I do that all the time. That's normal. You'll experience that as you get to my age.
Oh, is that what
happens?
Yeah,
you just start forgetting things, and then things just kind of blend in together. And you just have to.
Just all of it.
It's part of it, man.
A blur.
Yeah. Since I'm the senior citizen that works here at this dealership.
Right. That's right.
But yeah, so you got the nice little cargo nets up here. Fantastic fan. Create a breeze, which is nice.
Yeah.
Capable of pushing 920 cubic square feet of air through here.
All LED lights throughout, which is cool.
Yeah.
Bluetooth, SD card, USB, HDMI, aux in, DVD player. There's even an app that you can run for the stereo too, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, that app you can actually download on your phone, and you can control the whole thing from your phone.
Yeah,
which is nice. That's actually kind of cool.
TV antenna right here. So the way that you would do this is you crank it up. So let's see, up would be this way. So crank that all the way up. And then you can turn this whole thing where that entire antenna is moving on top of the roof there, so you can get the best reception possible. The other thing I might mention to you is I always like to throw my car keys up there, because if you leave it up, it's an easy thing, out of sight, out of mind, right?
Hey, so that's a good idea, mate.
That way you're
what
not
did you
driving
come up with
off.
That?
I'm just brilliant like that.
Wow. Boy, the efficiency is
stick around, man. Stick around.
I am, man. I'm not going anywhere. Yeah. That's pretty cool that you did that. I like that.
There it is.
Yeah, there you go.
Box AC, so it does have AC that pushes air this way and that way, both. And this has 2 CreateABreeze Fantastic fans, which I would probably choose those over an AC most days, because then you can go dry camping, run off your batteries
exactly.
And your set.
Yeah, there's not too many places that you're going to have to go if you're going up in the high mountains where you're going to need an AC. There
right.
might be a few spots, but most of the time our customers tell us they don't even use the AC. So,
does come with a TV, although it's not installed right now.
Right, so the swivel is kind of nice. So this can swing back and forth. And what's cool about this is that actually, when you get ready to watch TV, this comes off the bracket, and providing that we don't get tangled up in cords here, you can actually take this bracket off, take it to the outside, hook it onto the bracket that you have outside, and watch TV out there.
Cool.
Yeah.
And that little green light, I don't point it out often, but that little green light
TV
out there,
booster.
Make sure that you turn that sucker off
right.
if you're going to store your
camera. Can you see this Octavio on this side? Let's get our cameraman Octavio in here. So this is the green light. This is your TV booster. This is what Nate's referring to. So if you leave that on and you go to park your camper, chances are it'll probably drain your battery. So a lot of people will come in and say, hey, my battery's not charging or whatever. Chances are they left this on over an extended period of time, and that's what did it.
Either use a battery disconnect or just go into your battery and disconnect.
Disconnect. That's the best way.
Yeah.
Just disconnect the
that
battery.
That way you're not accidentally dry. Even if it's for a week, you can drain your battery yeah. and then be batteryless for a while. Or do the solar panel option. That's always, then you don't have to worry about it. You come back a week later and it's fully charged battery after you've drained it out.
Yeah, good feature.
Weekend.
Yeah, good feature.
So, yeah. You know, even in a small camper like this, they still have a decent sized drawer for pots and pans, another good sized drawer, another spot for stuff, scrubby brush spot, spots for all your plates, spots for all your cups, spots for all your bags of chips, or chocolate if it's Tom's case.
No, not my case. You're just trying to sabotage me for our marathon that we're getting ready to do in the end of July. You know, I'm going to feel bad for you on that day, man. I really am. Well, I'm really thinking about the really nice dinner that I'm going to have that you're going to buy me. That's the bet.
Yeah,
I think so.
That's okay. Your overconfidence is
possibly so.
Yeah.
But I cannot let a youngster like you beat me in a marathon.
We'll see.
So what's cool about this too? Is, oh boy, we're going to keep chiming in until this race. It needs to be over with, is what the problem is. So it's got a nice little knife holder right here on the back behind the stove. And what's cool is that this is going to allow you to, this glass counter top is going to allow you to have extra room to make sandwiches. But when you go to use the stove, this will flip up. Three burner stove. This comes off, which makes it really nice and easy to clean. And the cool feature about this as well is that you have an oven on here. So if you like
22 inch oven, which
22 inches, yeah.
You know, and you don't have to use it just for an oven. You can throw all your bread and chips in here too if you want. I mean, it's just extra storage.
Right.
And I didn't even point out this.
Yeah. Tons of different things. So you can heat up your coffee in here, make yourself some brownies, whatever you'd like to do. You hear that? It's raining.
It is raining.
And it's raining pretty good. You know, it's a good thing that it rains when we're talking about these roofs because people can see there's no leaks.
Yeah, they're pretty watertight.
They are.
It's cool because instead of the canvas that you have to spray all the seams and stuff like that, it has vinyl material.
Mm-hmm.
They do have breathable, and I'll show it. Actually, I don't show this very often, so I'll show it on this one. It does have right here, this part is canvas, and what it is it's a breathable material. So that the coach can still breathe and not condensate and stuff like that nearly as much. So, and you can unzip this guy, unzip that one, and it really makes it feel like you're hanging out outside in the great outdoors all of a sudden.
Yeah.
So that one unzips. This end one is a vinyl material. That one unzips.
Man, you're really showing the people.
Let's do it. There you go. So then you can see outside.
Yeah, now the general instruction and general care of this thing, guys, is, you know, the bottom line is that, you know, with this type of a canvas, you're just not gonna be able to fold it up and put it away wet. You're actually gonna have to let it dry out when you get home, you know, wipe it down with a cloth, and take care of that care, because that's where you're going to get the problems, and that's what a lot of the complaints have been with people that have had issues with these, is that they don't properly take care of your canvas. This is a great system. It lasts a super long time, but if you don't take your care of your canvas, it's going to break down.
Yeah, mold and mildew and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So same with awnings. You want to make sure you put your awnings
for
away
sure.
dry instead of wet.
Yeah, yep.
So fridge, it does have a 6 cubic foot refrigerator and separate freezer on top. A lot of units this size, they'll just do the bottom freezer and then a little tiny freezer inside there. It does have a nice little hanging wardrobe area right here. as well as extra storage down below, and then more storage even yet down below. Shower, which is
good. This is the best option right here.
So one switch, light switch on the side of the wall right here, extra large sink. Notice this too, because a lot of times these sinks are like half this size for some reason in RVs, which I didn't realize until I actually went camping. When you go to like wash your hands or like put water on your face, it makes a difference if it's like a decent size sink or not. Medicine cabinet here. Good size shower with elbow room and height right here.
Should we lock him in, Octavio?
Hey.
All right. See you later, mate. Have a great...
You know, that could be a problem, you know? I think that's like a fire issue.
You know, a creative genius would put a string right here so
that's
they could
right,
pull it up from this location.
Yeah.
I don't want to leave you in there.
And a decent size linen closet as well over here. Create a breeze.
You know, that's such a good upgrade that Rockwood did with those radius showers now.
Yeah,
it got
it's
away
nice.
From the shower curtain. It just makes it a little bit more homier. I think it makes it a little bit more roomier, actually,
it is nice.
To be honest with you. Because, you know, have you a shower curtain, especially one at home, where it kind of, I don't know, somehow it's kind of seems like it kind of sucks you in a little bit in the tub. You got to keep pushing the material out to give you.
Especially in RV showers, the way they used to do it, that shower curtain could easily pop out and then you're getting your entire floor all wet and stuff.
So
too,
that's a very nice upgrade that they did there.
Yep. So that's it. Camera, backup camera ready. You can join the Frog Club, Forest River Owners Club, which is free to join once you own a Forest River product.
Right.
So cool camper.
Yeah, very nice, very popular one for us. They're all popular, and we say that in our videos because we only bring in ones that are popular and that are sell very, very quickly. So we try to appease the masses, right?
That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
So come on down and see us here at the Gray Outdoors RV Company. My name's Tom. This is our general manager, Mate Parker here. He's all, you can see he's all dressed up and acting the part. I'm sales consultant, so we'll be happy to show you this 19 room. If you have any questions, give us a call, 970-313-4337, or visit us on the web.
TheGreatOutdoorsRV.com.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Take care.